Deadly and precise, the M240A1 incinerator unit is an integral part of the Colonial Marines' arsenal, though it is not without its disadvantages and limitations. When Ripley discovered the cocooned colonists on LV-426 were amidst the facility's fusion reactor, it was ordered by Lieutenant Gorman to limit the weaponry to flame units only in the infiltration of the Hive, much to the squad's noticeable objection. Though lacking in the supreme power carried by the pulse rifle and the smart gun, flame units have proven to be an effective weapon against the Xenomorph. Ripley's destruction of the Hive later on certainly must include a great deal of credit to the flame unit used, and it would even seem, as observed by Ripley much later on Fury 161, that the Xenomorphs may even have a fear of fire, making the weapon an invaluable tool of defense. The Colonial Marines Tech Manual describes the M240A1 as a lightweight, carbine-format flamethrower designed for use in close combat at the squad and fireteam level. Using pressurized, ultra-thickened naphthol fuel as a base and ignited by the nozzle burner, the M240 can shoot flame at targets up to 20 meters. Once a target has been hit, fuel droplets from the flamethrower will stick and continue to burn for approximately 30 seconds, with sufficient fuel in a standard fuel reservoir for a burst of up to 20 seconds. The M240 is undoubtedly one of the most fearsome weapons in the Marine inventory and has proven especially useful in close combat. However, it is unpopular with many of its operators, partly because of its short range and also because of the tendency of the fuel reservoir to rupture violently when hit by shrapnel or small arms fire. As noted in the unit schematics within the Weyland-Yutani report, this vulnerability can be overcome, as soldiers commonly tape scrap steel to the fore of the fuel reservoir to prevent such occurrences. Additionally noted in the tech manual, the M240 is 88 centimeters long and weighs 2.7 kilograms with a full reservoir. A valve at the rear of the incinerator is used to refuel the weapon. Alternatively, the reservoir can be screwed off and refilled or replaced separately. A twist valve on the flamethrower regulates the fuel flow, and a thumb switch on the hand grip electrically ignites the nozzle burner when depressed. The weapon is fired by squeezing the hand grip trigger and will continue firing until the trigger is released. The range of the M240 can be increased by making a high-angle shot, firing the flame unit up at an angle of about 45 degrees. The burning fuel then descends onto the target in an arc. In this way, shots can be made up to a range of 50 meters, though it is far less effective than direct fire in penetrating an armored firing slit or aperture. Another option is the blind angle burst, used during close-in fighting, such as within a built-up area. A flame burst from an M240 can be bounced off facing walls or surfaces to attack an enemy around a blind corner. Since the thickened fuel is difficult to extinguish, a commander must carefully consider the tactical area before authorizing the use of the flame. The amount of kindling and burnable debris must be assessed, as well as the environment. Just how effective, or ideal, flame units can be against xenomorphs remains a topic of debate. Weyland-Yutani has made assessments based on known encounters with the aliens and the weapons used against them. In the Weyland-Yutani report, the company notes and advises that the M240 should be modified when facing xenomorphs. The pressure-thickened naphthol accelerant is designed to adhere to any surface it touches and to burn slowly, creating as much damage and smoke as possible. We strongly feel that the effectiveness of fire against xenomorphs is more psychological/instinctual than physical. Reports from Furina 161 state that after being immersed in molten lead, the xenomorph was able to continue fighting. This indicates a significant resistance to heat. We recommend a petroleum-based fuel rather than naphthol, refined so that it burns hot, clean, and quickly. The heat should be enough to keep the xenomorphs at bay and burn facehuggers outright with a minimum of smoke interference. Long-burning fuels risk the structural integrity of any flammable environment. With all the chaos and confusion that took place during the initial attack in the alien hive, it's hard to determine if any aliens were in fact killed as a direct result of a flamethrower, though it can be confirmed that a chestburster was successfully killed by one. And Ripley most definitely incinerated a great many eggs in her raid, though for full-grown xenomorph attacks, she used the pulse rifle. Although the events as depicted in the comic book adaptation Newt's Tale show a different story. Maybe its effectiveness is still up for debate. What do you think? Is the M240 incinerator unit an ideal weapon against a xenomorph? Comment below and share your thoughts. And as always, thanks for watching, I really appreciate it, and if you like this video, please be sure to give it a like, and you can also hit the subscribe button to stay up to date with all the latest from the channel. If there's a topic you'd like covered, I'd love to hear your suggestion below, and I'll make sure to cover as much as I can. You can also follow Alien_Theory on Twitter, and Alien Theory YT on Facebook for more. And until next time, this is Alien Theory, signing off.